Hi, welcome to Crack Java. So in this video I'm going to discuss about the hashcode implementation in Java. So my last video about the equal method, where I have explained about the equal method and I have implemented the equal method with the real world example. So in this video I'm going to discuss about the hashcode method and its implementation, how we can implement this, how we can override the hashcode method, and what is the real use of the hashcode method. Okay, so let's get started. So the hashcode method in Java is present in the object class, and this method, using this method we can get any calculator integer value for an object. So generally the class member variable are used inside the hashcode function to get any values from the hashcode function. So the real world use of hashcode function is when objects are used in collection like hash map, set, etc. So when we use objects as a key in hash map or any other collection, it calls hashcode and equal method to check the object equality. So let's implement the hashcode. Let's check first how we can override the hashcode function, and then in my next video I will discuss this, how we can use the collection classes and what is the contact between equal and hashcode method. So there I will explain how we can use a object as a key in the map and what is the real usage of the hashcode in that scenario. So let's first override the hashcode function. So this is present into object class. So if you see our object class, so we have hashcode function in object class, so it's a native function. So if you see the description, so it returns a hashcode value for object. So this method is supported for benefit of hash tables. So I have already created a hashcode example class, so let's override the hashcode function here. So let's say in this class we have a integer value. Let's override the hashcode function. So this function should return an integer value, public int hashcode. Okay, so inside this function we can write any algorithm. So let's say return value into 10. Okay, so this will give us the value for this object of a class. So whenever, let's say we have 10 object of this class, so each object will have different value for the hash code. So it might also happen then thus different object have same values for this parameter, then in that case the hash code will be the same. So in this way we can override a hash code function in Java. So to clarify this more, let's discuss one more example. Let's say we have this example on the screen. Okay, so here to understand hash code function, let's say we have three buckets and each bucket have height and width. So now your task is to generate a number per object using height and width parameters. So someone say you to use height and width parameter and calculate some values. So you use hash code equal to height into 3 plus width into 3. So now when someone asks you to get particular bucket, so you have to again calculate the hash code and return the bucket. So whenever you get a bucket, you calculate a values, a hash code value, and whenever you pass that bucket, again you calculate the hash code and get that particular bucket and then provide to someone. So this is just in this way it generates a key which we can encode and we can provide it to the someone. So same way when we use object as a key in collections like map, they call hashcode method to get and put objects. Okay, so let's implement this. Let's say we have a bucket class. Let's create a bucket class. New class bucket. Okay, so in this class, let's say we have height and breadth. Okay, and say we have a width. And let's override the hashCode function. Okay, so let's return height into 3 plus width into 3. Okay, so let's create a main function to test this. Okay, now create some objects of bucket class. New buckets. So we have 3 buckets, so let's create 3 objects. B2, B3. Okay, so we can create a constructor as well, a parameterized constructor to pass the values for height and width. So height, width, so here we can set the values. Okay, so okay, this is int. Okay, so now we can pass the values from here to the constructor. Say we have 10 or 15. Here we have 20 and 30. Here we have again 10 and 15. Okay, so let's print the hash code now. Let's print the hash code for B1. Hash code. Okay, and let's print the hash code for B2 and B3 as well. Okay, let's run this. Okay, so we are getting different values. Yeah, because here we made a mistake. This should be hash code. So if we see the object class here, C is capital, so now this will work. Here also we need to change it. Okay, so now if we run this, okay, so it is calculating the values. If you see for B1 and B3, it is returning same hash code, 75 and 75. So it can happen that two objects might have same hash code also. So in that case, we use equal method to check the equality of the objects. Okay, so in this way, we can override the hash code in Java, and then we can provide any custom implementation for hash code. Yeah, so generally, we should use IDE to calculate the hash code. So if we can generate using IDE, so that will be better. So let's do that. Okay, so we need to select the parameters. Okay, so it is generating. So if you can see now, we have a hash code implementation that is generated by the IDE. So here, if you can see, it is using height and width parameters of the class, and then it has created one result variable and one prime variable. So it is using some custom implementation to generate the hash code, which is a better algorithm here. and it has also overridden the equal method as well. Okay, so using IDE we can also generate the hash code and equal method. Okay, so that's all about the hash code method. We can use hash code method generally when we want to put the object into the collection. So in that case, so that I will discuss into my next video. So see you next video. Bye bye.